Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier. So today in my this particular video, I am going to discuss how you can compute limit of a particular function around a point. Okay, and if you are working in mathematical computation related domain where limit is used, surely this particular video is going to help you. Okay, so let's start with what we generally write: CLC, clear all, close all, warning off. Okay, fine. Now to compute limit, we require one function. Suppose the function I am taking, this one. First function for demonstration purpose, this one I am taking. And here, I am writing f of x equal to this one. Okay. Now, x is one variable. So, this kind of notation, if you want to use where x you want to use as like symbolic variable, that time you can write sims x. Okay. So this will be creating one symbolic variable x. Like here, if I just run this particular part, see in command window, if I write x and hit enter, you will be getting back x only, x equal to x. Why? Because it is symbolic expression, we are not assigning any particular value. Okay, now suppose you want to get the figure of this particular function. For that we are going to use fplot. Okay, generally we use plot to plot something. Here we are going to use fplot. Okay, so you can write help fplot and hit enter, or you can search the documentation in internet as well. Okay, so what it is saying here, fplot function, here fplot is used to plot 2D function, plots the function fun between the limits of the current axis within default value minus 5 to 5. If we want, we can specify the range of x values for which we want to plot as second parameter. Okay, so let's do that. So if plot of fx comma, suppose I want to plot from minus 2 to 8 in x axis. Okay, so minus 2 to 8, right? And maybe suppose blue color I want to plot with line width as maybe 2. Okay, let's check how the function looks like. No doubt from the expression itself we can say that it will be looking like kind of parabola shape. Okay, so let's see. And here beautifully it comes. Okay, this is the parabola. Now suppose I am asking you, what is the value, okay, when x value tends to 3. Okay, that is, you have to compute the limit of this particular function around 3. How you can compute? Very simple. Answer equal to, okay, I am writing like this. Answer equal to, you have to use limit function in MATLAB, pass the first function, then here x tends to 3, right? Here we have to compute the limit of the function where x tends to 3. Okay, here no need to put this particular variable, rather here we can put a. So a will be storing the value of the function when x tends to 3. What will be the value? Simple 3 minus 4 whole square, which is nothing but 1. Okay, let's check. So just see, if I have to evaluate selection and go to command window, here when execution will be completed, double arrow will come. And here if I just write a and hit enter, we should get 1, because the limit function value should be evaluated as 1, which you can easily understand from the mathematics also. Now suppose I want to plot that particular point here, how I can plot? Very simple. So for plotting, first I am using hold on, because I want to plot in the same figure, then plot. Okay, so for plotting purpose, what we require? We require 2 piece of x coordinate values, 2 piece of y coordinate values. And then suppose red color with this kind of line style we want to plot. Y coordinate, so basically what I want a horizontal line and a vertical line. Okay, so when I want a horizontal line, okay, that is at, so first let's plot the vertical line. Okay, vertical line plotting will be very simple. Suppose we want to compute the limit value around value 3. So here both the x values will be no doubt 3, right? And what will be the y value? Y value will be, I want that it should take from this particular figure. So for that we can write like this, that is get, okay, GCA, then ylim, okay? So I am requesting to take the y limit from this graph, and this should be in red color. Let's check whether the vertical line is coming or not. So x limit will be same starting and ending part, and y limit I want to take from figure window. That's why I am writing like this. Why it is coming like completely black? Let me check once. Maybe some other issues happening. Let me check. Yes, see now perfectly the particular one vertical line which we want. Okay, that is for this particular line, x starting from here. Okay, x value 3, here also x value 3. X value not changing, y value just taking from figure. Now plot x value, y value, one horizontal line we want to plot. Okay, where for the horizontal line it is quite clear what will be the x value range, that it should take from figure window. So I'll be just simply copying this one, and here it I'll be pasting. Instead of that I'll be writing x limit. So x limit it will be taking from here, and y limit it will be taking from here. Okay, AA, because A is storing the limit value, and same kind of line style I want to give. Okay, let's check now. Yes, we are getting. Okay, so like this you can show that the limit value is this one. Okay, I hope how I have drawn is clear to you. Now let's check a very interesting function. Okay, this one, let's check. And suppose I want to get the range for -10 to 10. Okay, here double semicolon coming, let me delete. Just to evaluate selection, let's check how this particular function looks. Okay, so you can see the function looks like this. Here there is a discontinuity. Okay, here if you are going in with respect to this line, if you are going in left hand side, basically it is going to positive infinity, limit explodes to positive infinity. If you are going to right side, limit explodes to negative infinity. Okay, so this one is x equal to -6. Just now if we put our mouse pointer, we can see x near -6. So now in this particular discontinuity case, you know that left limit and right limit are going to differ. That time how you can compute? Very simple, that technique only I am going to show you. So f of x already taken. Okay, now here I can write in the command window, I am writing limit. First let us check what is our f of x. I have evaluated that, so our f of x is this one. Now suppose I want to compute this f of x value with when x tends to -6 in the left side direction. Okay, which is just if you press tab, it will be coming. Okay, let's check. It should go to infinite. See, as expected, we are getting from the graph also, we can match. Okay, similarly here, instead of left, we are doing right, then it should go to negative infinity. Negative infinite we are getting. So this is just one particular case which I wanted to show you, that like left limit, right limit might differ. Okay, sometime as you know. So that particular evaluation you can do using the extra piece of parameter, while left or right that you need to pass. Okay, that's it. So this is all about our limit concept which I wanted to discuss. I hope you have enjoyed this. This is all for my this video. If you find this video helpful, then please like, share and comment. Subscribe my channel if you have not subscribed till now, and don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of my latest videos. Thank you.